Message begins right now. Beloved Masters, in awe, with a sense of wonder and gratitude, we watch as thousands upon thousands of you, the bearers of light, answer the latest clarion call and assume the task of anchoring via your physical vessel the magnificent gift of love, life, light from the Supreme Creator to the crystalline grid system and the Earth. If you have been following our messages over the past months, you are now familiar with the concepts of the cities of light, the crystalline grid system, and the term adamantine particles, which is the pure divine love, light originated within the heart, mind of the Supreme Creator and is the substance of all creation. The term love and light go together, for the two are inexorably connected to the whole. The complete, full-spectrum light or electromagnetic radiation from the source contains all that is necessary to create universes and worlds without end. Life is the Creator's love made manifest. Your love is the activator of adamantine particles. It is important that you have a good understanding of these advanced concepts, what they mean and how they affect all creation in this universal experience, and it behooves you to seek out and study this information until it is firmly imprinted upon your mind. As you return to self-mastery and, once more, fully assume your role as co-creators of a new galactic experience, it is vital that you have a comprehensive understanding of the universal laws and how to effectively use your allotment of divine light substance. We often give you new information that must be accepted or rejected via your gift of discernment. If it is to be accepted as your truth, it must be fully understood and assimilated in order to become a part of your philosophy of life, and then it must be put into practice. It is also important that we convey to you the practical applications of our wisdom teachings so that you will have a good understanding of the cause and effect situations that can arise as you strive to integrate each new level of awareness. As many of you who have faithfully followed our teachings are aware, each dimensional environment resonates to a specific range of frequency patterns, with each higher dimension vibrating within a higher and more refined range. As you made your journey into outer space and into the lower dimensions, each level resulted in a separation of consciousness from your higher self to some degree. In other words, within your mental body, the frequency patterns for each level of consciousness, or dimension, were stored in what we have termed light packets of wisdom. These were encased in membranes of light or a veil which restricted access to the various higher dimensional consciousness levels until you were, once again, resonating to that level of consciousness. It is time for the veils of unconsciousness to be lifted, beloveds, so that you can remember the vastness of who you are, the grand experiences you have had, and the bright future that is before you. As we have done in the past, we will draw on portions of some of the thousands of personal messages that we have conveyed through this messenger to you, our faithful followers. As you return to unity consciousness and reunite with the multifacets of your oversoul, twin flame and divine self, you will remember more and more of the vast and diverse experiences you have had throughout this universal experience. We ask you to turn within and listen or feel an echo of remembrance as we convey to you critical information for your assimilation, information which is only a minuscule portion of your rich past. Dearly beloved, you have played the game of being the masterful one and in control of your life and destiny, and you have also played at being a follower, taking the easy road and often allowing others to make your decisions and direct your life for you. This is a balancing lifetime for you, whereby you are remembering that you are a magnificent and mighty being of light. You are learning to balance the dynamic power you carry within with love and compassion for those around you who are not yet ready to awaken to their mastery. It is not easy to be an earth angel. Love is the fuel of angelic beings, and you have always thought that if you loved enough, others would love you in return. You are learning to set boundaries and to value yourself, for without self-worth you cannot fully access the divine love of the Creator that is your birthright. You joyously came forward when the call went out for volunteers to be a part of the great experiment which was to take place on a planet whose spiritual name is Gaia, which you know as Earth. You have lived and been deeply involved in many of the great civilizations during the long history of Earth. You have always enjoyed life with great passion and gusto and have experienced the heights and the depths of life, and in doing so are now able to help lift the mass consciousness from the depths of the third dimension back into the beauty and wonder of the higher dimensions. Your discontent is a result of seeking that which you desire outside of yourself rather than turning inward. We also want to make you aware that part of your mission was to experience the physical vessel in its most dynamic form. Therefore, you have always had a great passion and strong desires. Sometimes you have tried to stifle these feelings, but they have been an underlying current that cried out to be acknowledged. Your greatest desire for this lifetime was to return all the facets of your earthly being to harmony and balance so that you could begin the reunification process with your multidimensional self. Deep within, you are aware of how important it is for you to honor and integrate your feminine nature, the gentle, intuitive, creative and inward-focused energies, as well as developing and using your masculine attributes. Also, strive to be strong, yet gentle, outward focused as you tap into your inner intuition. You, along with others, are needed as transducers and transmitters of the neurofine energy from the Creator, in order to help move humanity and the Earth through this important time of transition. That is why I am calling my legions together once more, and making my presence known to those of you who have an important part to play in the great drama that is now unfolding on Earth. Through our teachings, we are giving you all the information you will need to begin to access the wisdom of your higher self, and as you learn to use your pyramid of power, light in the fifth dimension, you will quickly tap into the galactic prosperity gateway where all the riches of the universe are stored. It is your divine birthright to live in abundance and prosperity. You have just forgotten. First, you must realize you are worthy, and then as you practice and learn the necessary skills, those things that you desire in your life will begin to manifest. Abundance comes in many forms, so seek an abundance of love, joy, good health and vitality, as well as all the things you require to live a full and comfortable life. As you begin to create miracle after miracle, those around you will want to know what you are doing. That is when you share the techniques, beliefs and wisdom you have claimed as your own. That is when you will become a true self-master. First you will teach by example and through your actions, and finally through words. Focus on what is right in your world and look for the best in those around you, for that is what you will reinforce. You can change the world around you, one thought at a time. You now have greater and greater amounts of cosmic life force energy available to you. However, you are responsible for how you utilize that energy. You must stay firmly grounded to the Earth, as you reach higher and higher into the refined dimensions of expression, and it is of vast importance to your physical well-being that you learn to balance and harmonize your personal energetic grid system, called your auric field or Adam, Eve Cadman perfected body of light. Dear one, you carry core memories of suppression, feelings of guilt and betrayal. You have always believed that love would overcome any adversity. Therefore, you have most often put others' wishes and desires before your own. Your desire to serve has, lifetime after lifetime, put you in a subservient role, and it has been difficult for you to take back your power and control of your destiny. You are striving to balance your empathetic nature with a desire to express and validate your own worth. Deep within, you realize that you must return to empowerment and wholeness if you are to enjoy a satisfying, loving relationship with a soulmate or those who come into your life. You, as a multitude of others, are in the midst of an accelerated transformational process, whereby you are continually processing distorted energy from past lifetimes, core issues from deep within. As you awaken to your God consciousness and the magnificence of who you are, it is your own private journey and no one else can tell you how to proceed. Do not fear change, beloved. Allow those things that no longer serve you to fall by the wayside. Step through the fear and see it melt away, leaving a bright new future before you. Use the opportunities that come your way as stepping stones to your own empowerment. Anything you do should resonate deep within your soul and should inspire you and bring you joy. What is your passion? What is your deepest heart's desire? You can have or become anything you can envision. One of your major tasks is to fill yourself with the unconditional love of your God self so that you will project balanced and harmonious energies instead of looking to others to give you a sense of self-worth or wholeness. You must learn to set boundaries as you lovingly begin to speak your truth and take back your personal power. You can only change yourself, but as you empower yourself and begin to radiate a sense of peace, power and compassion, you will withdraw the energies of neediness and lack, and those around you will either benefit and grow from the experience, or they will find someone else to play the cosmic drama of life with them. Before you came into this lifetime, you promised to be our representative on Earth. Within, you have all the wisdom you will need to fulfill your mission. As doubts arise, remember, all of your experiences from the past, whether they were successful or seemingly failures, have given you a wealth of experience to draw upon. We are endeavoring to help you remember your magnificence, so that you will know that you have accomplished many times before that which we ask of you now. You have soared the universe with me and the legions of light, and we have created many wondrous worlds and has many exciting adventures together. From the time you first externalized from the heart of the Creator into your individualized spark of consciousness, you birthed a desire to experience as many facets of the Creator as possible. Spirit is whispering to you, and if you answer the call, magnificent vistas and opportunities beyond your wildest imagining will emerge, and we will be there to guide and inspire you. As always, it is time to fulfill the deepest yearnings of your heart as you reclaim your self-mastery and become the co-creator of the highest order on the physical plane of existence. You are being given an opportunity to integrate all the wondrous qualities of the 12 rays of God consciousness so that you may assume your rightful role as an earthly purveyor of love, light. You will then have the wisdom and abilities to assist others to move through the challenges of transformation. Each day, endeavor to make the highest choices and learn to stay in the moment, for that is the only time you can access your God power. Do not dwell on the past, nor continually focus on the future, but always strive to achieve your highest potential in each and every moment. See the challenges in your life as opportunities as you learn to let go of old self-limiting ways. Remember, during these times of great change, you can make a difference. Allow your radiance to shine forth for all to see. Many such as you are experiencing a divine discontent, as well as many life changes at this time. Things that used to bring you pleasure no longer satisfy, and you may have lost any common interest with many of your friends. This is because your soul self is nudging you to move forward, to expand your vision and to take control of your destiny. You are a co-creator, beloved, either of pain, suffering and limitation, or of love, joy, peace, and abundance. The choice is yours. The diamond core, God cell that is deep within your sacred heart center, is now in the process of being activated more fully so that your radiance may pour forth out into the world to those who are receptive. Once you truly begin to align with the positive energies of your soul and God rays, your ambition, efficiency, and practicality will assist you to make astounding progress. You have the tools and inward abilities to achieve anything you desire in this lifetime and beyond, beloved. Remember, when your energy signature is based on sacred love, you attract adamantine particles, and when you are aligned with your highest destiny for the greatest good of all, you are radiating these divine particles of love/light/life. We are here to assist you in every way possible to attain spiritual illumination. I am Archangel Michael. End of the message. Much love to all you soul sisters, brothers. Watch my previous videos for better understanding. New subscribers will be updated with the latest articles and informations. We hope this channel has helped you discover where to start on your actual spiritual path. It's a good karma to put to like, comment, subscribe and share with your beloved ones. Leave your suggestion in the field below. All the love to you, beautiful.